Hey, everyone. Let's take a look at number eight. So we have here, in order to compete in the America's Cup sailboat race, a boat must satisfy this rule, which is ugly to look at, but we'll make sense of it, where L is the length in meters of a boat, S is the area in square meters of the sails, and D is the volume in cubic meters of water displaced by the boat. If a boat has a length of 20, that is going to be a number I'm going to want. There's my length value. And a sail area of 300 square meters, what is the minimum allowable value for D? So what they're telling me is instead of L, I'm going to put 20, right? And instead of S here, I'm going to put 300. And then I'm going to solve for D. And it's an ugly inequality, but it's going to be algebra that we're using. So let's go ahead and start to put this together. So I'm going to have 20 plus 1.25 times the square root of 300 minus 9.8 times the cube root of D. And I'll put that over 0.6. Oops, excuse me, that jumped. Let me move that back out. Over 0.679, and that's got to be less than or equal to 24. Okay, so there's a bunch of ways I could go after this, but the first thing I'm going to do, I want to get rid of the fractions. So I'm going to multiply both sides by 0.679. All right, and that's going to cancel here. So I'm going to have now 20 plus 1.25 times the square root of 300 minus 9.8 times the cube root of D will be less than or equal to, and I'll get my calculator out, and that will give me 16.30. All right, so the next thing I would do on my calculator is crunch 1.25 times the square root of 300. And when I do that, I get 21.65. So now I'm looking at 20 plus 21.65 minus 9.8 times the cube root of D. It's got to be less than or equal to 16.30. And if I look on the left side of that inequality, I can see that these are like terms, so I can go ahead and add them together. So I'm looking at 41.65 minus 9.8 times the cube root of D. That's got to be less than or equal to 16.30. All right, so I'm going to subtract 41.65 from each side of the inequality. And let's see what that leaves us with. That leaves us with negative 9.8 times the cube root of D. It's got to be less than or equal to, and when I crunch this on my calculator, I get negative 25.35. Let me move this up here. All right, so let me rewrite this. I had negative 9.8 cube roots of D has got to be less than or equal to negative 25.35. All right, I would like to isolate that cubic term. So I'm going to divide by negative 9.8, and keep in mind when you divide an inequality by a negative number, it changes the direction of the inequality. So I'm going to have here the cube root of D is now greater than or equal to, and this number over here is going to be 2.59. So I do want to mention that, sorry. Let me zoom back up. That was fun. I don't even know what I hit. Cool. All right, so what I was trying to say is this was a less than or equal to, and when I divided by that negative 9.8 on both sides, it changed the direction of the inequality. All right, and then the last thing I need to do is just cube both sides. All right, and when you cube a cube root, that cancels. So D has got to be greater than or equal to, and when I do 2.59 cubed on my calculator, I'm going to get 17.31. And this was D. If we look at the units for D, it was cubic meters. So let me go find that one. So I see 17.3 cubic meters, and that's going to be my answer. All right, thanks so much. Bye.